Now, what is the vertical circular motion in a loop? In a loop means, imagine there is a one cylinder. That's a cylinder surface, cylindrical surface. You can take like an anything, sphere, cylinder, anything you can take, no problem. Now, instead of like a pendulum string, now I'm taking the one object, one ball of mass m. Now I want to give the velocity u at the bottommost point, so that what will happen? It has to complete the vertical circle and come back. And what is the radius of the cylinder? Radius of the cylinder is r. Radius of the cylinder is r. Then we have to see that what are the conditions on u so that it will complete the vertical circle. Now see, what are the force acting on this ball? Ball or particle, you can take anything. So once ball has gone to here, then there will be some normal reaction acting. Normal reaction will be perpendicular to the surface, means normal reaction is towards the center, and mg will act downward direction. Let us say it is rotated by an angle theta, then I can say that this angle is theta, then I can make components of mg cos theta, okay na, and this is mg sin theta. Mg sin theta will be the tangential force, mg cos theta will, a normal reaction and mg cos theta will contribute centripetal force, and here speed is something like in v. Let us say we are projecting with velocity u and it is having the speed v. Okay, so then what is the centripetal force? I can write down n minus mg cos theta is equal to mv square by r. Am I right? N is acting towards the center. Mg cos theta is acting away from the center. Then what is the net force acting towards the center? M minus mg cos theta. That is equal to mv square by r. Then v and u relation also you can write down. V and u by energy conservation you can write down. This is the centripetal force. So let us say this is the A point. So at point A. Now similarly I write down one more equation, and this is the object. Suppose that ball has gone to this position. From here to it has gone to the highest point. At the highest point it is having the velocity v. Then how the forces will act? Mg will act towards the center. Even normal reaction will act away from the surface. See, on the ball away from the surface. This is the contact surface. Away from the surface, normal reaction will act downward. Normal reaction acting on the ball we are writing. Normal reaction always act towards the center, you can remember. Okay, because normal reaction is perpendicular to the surface, contact surface. Perpendicular to contact surface means perpendicular to tangent. That means normal reaction will act towards the center or along the radial. I told you this also. Whenever it's a spherical body, the normal reaction will act along the radial. Okay, and away from the surface. Now object is in the inner surface, so away from the surface will be towards the center. Now what is the equation I can write out at highest point? At highest point of the journey, what is the centripetal force? Centripetal force is equal to, I can write down, n plus mg. See, n and mg both are acting towards the center. So n plus mg is equal to mv square by r. So let us say this is v dash, I am writing as v dash, okay? Just to differ v and v dash, these two velocities. For looping the circular motion and energy conservation I can use. From here to here, highest point only I am taking. If I do the energy conservation, this is zero potential energy level. Potential energy is zero, let us say. Okay, na? If I am using the energy conservation, I will get half mu square is equal to half mv square plus mg into, I can write down, 2R. 2R is the height. 2R is the height. Mg into 2R will be the potential energy. Got it? So then u square is equal to v square plus, I can write down 4gr. U square is equal to v square. Cancel the m. Then u square, v square, multiply the 2, 4gr. Then this is the one equation, this is the other equation. We want to find out the u minimum so that it will complete the vertical circle. If u value is minimum, then v value will become minimum. If v value is minimum, then what value should be minimum? N value is minimum because mg won't change. Mg is a constant factor. So the normal reaction should be minimum. What is the minimum normal reaction at the highest point? Can be zero. Even if normal reaction is zero here, then mg will act as a centripetal force. It will make the particle to move in circular path. Just the same as previous pendulum only, but I don't know how many of you identified this. Pendulum tension will act. Here normal reaction is acting. Again, leaving the circular path, let us say leaving the circular path if you are talking about. If you are talking about leaving the circular path, which value should be 0? N value should be 0. Whereas if it is pendulum and string, leaving the circular path, what has to be zero? String has, I mean, tension in the string has to be zero. So that tension here, normal reaction, that those forces only differ, remaining all will be same. You will get the same answer also. See now, so what is the minimum normal reaction can act? Zero. Okay, now let us say this is the first equation and this is the second equation. Now first equation will become normal reaction minimum value plus mg is equal to m into v minimum square by r. Okay, na? So the normal reaction is zero, minimum normal reaction is zero. So then what is the v minimum is? V minimum is equal to gr is equal to v minimum square. M and m cancel out, gr is equal to v minimum square. Now keep the v minimum square over here. Then u minimum you will get, u minimum square is equal to v minimum square gr plus 4gr, which will be equal to 5gr. Then minimum velocity is equal to, minimum velocity is equal to root 5gr, which is same as pendulum, which is root 5gl. There root 5gl, because l is the radius of circular path, here r is the radius, so we are getting root 5gr. Means this particular circular motion and simple pendulum vertical circular motion not differ, they are not different, they are same, except their string is there. Here, I mean, in the place of tension, normal reaction will act. Okay, na? Just see that. Now you can write down the condition for oscillation. Now tell me, what is the condition for oscillation? You can write down condition of oscillations. What is the condition for oscillation? Condition for oscillation, I can write down u value is less than root 2gr. There it is root 2gl. Here u value is root 2gr, less than root 2gr. Similarly, what is the condition for leaving the circular path? Be root 2gr less than u and less than root 5gr. If u value is in between root 2gr and root 5gr, then this particle will leave the circular path at what place? In this region, after 90 and before 180. All of you understood? So normal reaction will be zero. Leaving the condition for leaving the circular path means normal reaction has to be zero here. Whereas in the simple pendulum case or pendulum case, pendulum vertical circular motion case, tension has to be zero. Okay. So this particular phenomenon also called as looping the loop. So this is the one experiment. It's called as looping the loop. See. So he is releasing from one height, because as height value increases, the velocity at the bottommost point also will increase. Here at the bottommost point, whatever velocity is there, that depends on the height released. So as the height value increases, u value increases. As u value is more than root 5gr, it will complete the vertical circle. But if u value is less than root 5gr, it won't complete the vertical circle. Okay, na? See, he is releasing from this height. It is able to complete the vertical circle, right? Now he will release from this height later. This height. Now it won't complete. It is leaving here. See, means it is leaving after turning by 90 angle, before 180 angle. So this is the region where it will leave. Okay, you can see it.